Good morning, friends, and welcome to the pre-market view. US markets were flat yesterday, no major data points. European markets, however, were up anywhere from 0.25 to almost about 0.5%. And when we look at the Asian markets today morning, both Nikkei as well as Hang Seng are up about 0.25%. And SGX Nifty is also suggesting that we're going to open up about 15 points higher. In terms of flows, friends, we had negative flows across the domestic institutional investors as well as FIIs. So in the cash market, FIIs were net sellers to the tune of 461 crore, and the domestic institutions were also sellers to the tune of 118 crore. And in index futures, we have seen FIIs selling about 418 crore. Our own markets were under pressure to start off with. There was a knock off almost about 70 odd points on the Nifty, but they managed to recover in the last couple of hours of trade, and eventually the Nifty was down only about 20 odd points. But overall sentiment continues to be a little calm, as we had some kind of an uncertainty building up in the Middle East, and the Brent crude prices continue to remain at a higher level of about 114-115 levels. So a bit of a sentiment dampener there. Also, the fact that some of the parts in northern India, the monsoon has arrived, but overall monsoon progress has not been up to the mark, which is again playing in the minds of the market participants. So I think the markets would remain broadly in a range of maybe about 7400 to about 7600, at least till this expiry. On that note, let me invite Sadhana to take us through important FNOQs and ideas that we can have from the FNO side.
Good morning, friends. Let's have a view on derivatives. In yesterday's trade, we have seen that after a positive start, markets lost its momentum in absence of any positive trigger and entered into a red terrain, as weakness was seen in many of the blue chip counters such as McDowell, ONGC, Reliance Industries, and Nifty finally snapped its session with a margin loss of 0.12%. In this period, we have seen that short buildup was observed by market players, as around 3.92 lakh shares were added in open interest, and Nifty futures price decreased hardly by 8 rupees to 9 rupees. On the other hand, cost of carry increased significantly by 98% from 6.76% to 13.41%, and Nifty futures premium also increased from 11 points to 19 odd levels. On the options front, PCR has decreased from 0.83 to 0.80, which is clearly indicating that call option has added good number of shares in yesterday's trade than put option. In yesterday's trade, call option has added around 33 lakh shares in open interest, whereas put option has added around 4 lakh shares in open interest. IV increased marginally by 0.86% from 18.58 to 18.74. In the options activity, as of now, we have seen that 7,600 stands with good number of shares in open interest, followed by 7,700 in this series. And put option, we have seen that reduction is happening from past couple of trading sessions, 7,500 put option, followed by 7,400 put option. There are 6 securities in bank period today. That means no one can take the fresh positions of June month. One is Dish TV, second is GMR Infra, third is HDIL, fourth is RB Real Estate, fifth is L&T Finance Holding, and sixth is Unity. Yesterday, FIIs were net buyers of 1,000 odd crores in future and options segment. They were net sellers of 460 crores in index futures. Our 5-day CVM stands at 7570. Lower range for the market would be 7500, and higher range would be 7700. 7500 might act as a good support on closing basis. If Nifty breaks this level, we may see downward pressure on the Nifty. At Singapore, Nifty is up by 13 points, which is at 7565. So we may see marginal flattish to positive start in Nifty futures today. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Let me take you through the Sher Khan pre-market action, starting with actionable ideas for today. Friends, for infrastructure and housing NBFC, some positive news, as the Corporate Affairs Ministry has allowed the infrastructure finance companies and infrastructure debt fund and NBFCs to raise the secured debentures for a period of up to 30 years. And in addition, the housing finance companies have been allowed the relaxed norms for maintaining the debenture redemption reserve. So these developments are positive for the infrastructure and housing finance companies, particularly PFC, REC, PFS, and IDFC. So one can go long on BSE with the stop loss of about 288 and a target of about 303 to about 308, and LIC Housing Finance one can go long there with the stop loss of about 311 and a target of about 327 to about 333. Orchid Chemicals, some positive news is the company has got a US FDA approval for its ANDA called Esopiclone tablet. So one can go long there with a stop loss of 436 and a target of about 458 to about 468. Here is the watch list for the day traders with a list of stocks with positive and negative bias. Stocks with positive bias are Titan, Reliance Capital, Investment Bank and HCL Tech. And the stocks with negative bias are United Spirits, ONGC, SAIL and Adani Port. In other developments, SEBI has proposed that all the listed PSUs should have a minimum 25% of the public shareholding in 3 years time. Currently there are about more than 36 PSUs where the government holds more than 75% stake, and some of these are Coal India, NHPC and NTPC. And now the top 200 companies versus the top 100 companies recommended earlier will be able to divest using the OFS route. And in order to increase the retail participation, 10% of the total quota would be set aside for the retail investors. So, in other news, the Diageo's open offer for United Spirits has got a good response. And overall, the number of shares which have been tendered are 69.9 million shares, as against the total size of the offer of about 37.7 million. So the acceptance ratio is likely to be about 55.18% versus the earlier expectations of about 70%. And ARCOM arm is going to lay the Mumbai-Singapore subsea cable, which is basically the submarine cable unit of ARCOM. So some bit of a positive news for ARCOM on that front. And government indicated that it may allow private FM radio to broadcast news channels, news with its channels having an option of picking content from the 3 to 4 sources and not just the All India Radio bulletins. And additionally, the IT minister has also indicated that the phase 3 expansion of the FM radio, under which over 800 FM channels will be auctioned across cities, is also looks to be expedited. So positive news for the FM radio channel. So one can look out for some kind of action in this particular space. And Jet Airways Alliance with Etihad has again run into some kind of problems, with Singapore issuing notice seeking comments from the public on the proposed deal. That's it from all of us, friends. Have a great weekend and see you on Monday morning.